I just want to start this video by explaining about spirit guides, channeling, different misconceptions that people have. First of all, spirit guides. Now, these could be beings that were prearranged by you before you came into this lifetime. And they could also be someone that came about while you were in this lifetime because of reaching out for a higher awareness, needing help, whatever. So, the thing of it is with spirit guides is that with everything that's good, the opposite, of course, is there's bad. And when people first get in touch with the universe, like I did many years ago by using the Ouija board, because I was into what they call full body channeling, I was listening and I was hearing people talking about their guides coming in and their souls leaving. And so I was under that misconception 20 years ago that that was something you can do. Well, anyway, when I had asked my spirit guide to do a walk-in for me, basically all hell broke loose. I was opened up to a lot of hate. So you really want to get into the universe with a lot of help, either a physical teacher or your spirit guide, and you know, hopefully everything works out in that regards for you. But over 20 years I have learned a lot about this universe because of the things that I physically and mentally went through. And to say that if I had been a weaker soul, a weaker mind, I may not be here today. Because many times I heard in my mind, kill her, or why doesn't she kill herself, or why doesn't she die? And it was because of the misconception about reincarnation and incarnations. Because the thing about incarnations, you can be a spirit who's a very evolved soul, and you can come into a body to help that body out during that lifetime, and that's called a walk-in. There's a lot of information out there about it. But you can have, with that being open and everything like that, again, being good and there's bad, there are a lot of souls out there that think just because the good people can do it, well, why not them? Why can't they do it? So you have to be very careful. Even if you're not getting in touch with the universe, there are still things that can happen to you. I mean, everybody's heard of divine intervention or spirit possession. So the main thing about it is that you have to be strong to do something like this. You just can't be involved in drugs or alcohol or weak-minded, suicidal, because there are those out there who do not want you to have your power. They don't want you to know about yourself. If you knew about yourself, then guess what? You're empowered and they can't control you. And whether people believe it or not, there are situations in life that you're controlled. You're controlled by your parents because they want you to behave. You're controlled by your environment because of your culture upbringing. You are controlled by your boss because he gives you your paycheck every week and so you dance to the boss's tune. So there's different things that you can so-called be controlled over. And minor, major, it doesn't matter. It's the main thing of it is that you allow it.